Slow and steady wins the race. What does it remind you of? Yes, it must have reminded you of the famous story of the tortoise and the rabbit. Well, as the story goes, once upon a time, there was a rabbit who boasted that he could run faster than his friend Tortoise, and he challenged him to have a race. They had a race and the rabbit ran really fast. After some time, he saw that the tortoise was far behind him. He thought that the tortoise is too slow and he could rest for some time. So he slept. Meanwhile, while the rabbit was sleeping, the tortoise kept on walking and walking. So the tortoise walked steadily towards the finishing line without even stopping for a moment. After some time, the rabbit woke up and he was shocked to see that the tortoise was way ahead of him. So he ran as fast as he could. But in the end, he lost the race. So here, we list down the distance traveled by rabbit in different time periods and the distance traveled by tortoise in different time periods through the course of the race. Now we plot this information on a graph. Let us first plot the graph for tortoise. So this is the time taken by tortoise at different points in race, and this is the distance traveled by tortoise in these time periods. We draw the distance time graph for tortoise. We mark time on the horizontal axis or the x-axis. We mark distance traveled on the vertical axis or the y-axis. We mark the points. For example, for time equal to 0, distance traveled is 0. So we mark a point at 0, 0. At time equal to 10 seconds, distance traveled is 4 meters. So at 10 seconds, distance traveled is 4 meters. Similarly, we mark all the points and we join them using a line. And this is the distance time graph for the tortoise. It shows the distance traveled by the tortoise at different points in time. Now, seeing this graph, we can find that in the first 20 seconds, tortoise had traveled a distance of 8 meters. In the next 20 seconds, that is from 20 to 40 seconds, tortoise had traveled 16 meters minus 8 meters, that is another 8 meters. So we can say that equal distances are covered by tortoise in equal intervals of time. So what do we say? That tortoise is traveling with uniform speed because he covered equal distances in equal intervals of time. We know that speed is equal to distance by time. So we can write distance is equal to speed into time. Now since speed is constant, we are talking about uniform speed or constant speed. Since speed is constant, we can say that distance is proportional to time. So distance is proportional to time. So what will happen if we plot a graph of distance versus time? We'll get a straight line graph which passes through the origin. So the distance time graph for uniform speed is a straight line through the origin because we know that distance is proportional to time when speed is constant. Now this graph tells the distance traveled by tortoise at different time periods. So it has all the information about the distance traveled and time taken. So given this graph, we can calculate the speed of the tortoise at different time periods. How? Let us see. Now, in this graph, the rise or the change in y coordinate is equal to distance, because if we take any two points and subtract them, we'll get the distance traveled. The run or the change in x coordinate is equal to time taken. We know that slope of a graph is given by rise by run. Rise is equal to distance traveled, run is equal to time taken. So slope is equal to distance by time, which is equal to speed. So slope of a distance time graph tells us the speed. So slope of a distance time graph gives us speed. And since this is a straight line graph, we see that the slope of this graph is constant. Since the slope of this graph is constant and slope is equal to speed, we can say speed of this graph is constant. So if the distance time graph is a straight line, it indicates uniform speed. Here we see that just by looking at the graph, just by having a glance at the graph, we can say that the tortoise is moving with uniform speed. We do not have to calculate anything. And this is the benefit of using graphs, that just by having a look at the graph, we can gather a lot of information. So what we have studied is we have studied that if a body moves with uniform speed, a distance time graph will be a straight line. And also the other way around, that if the distance time graph of a body is a straight line, we can infer that it is moving with uniform speed. Now, for a straight line motion in one direction, magnitude of displacement is equal to distance, because the direction of motion is not changing and direction is constant. So displacement will be equal to distance. So we get the same graph for displacement versus time, because displacement is equal to distance. So this is the displacement time graph for tortoise, and it is the same as that of the distance time graph of tortoise. Now, what is the slope of displacement time graph? Well, again, rise is equal to displacement and run is equal to time taken. So slope is equal to rise by run, which is equal to displacement by time, equal to velocity. We know velocity is equal to displacement divided by time. So slope of displacement time graph gives us velocity, just like the slope of distance time graph gives us speed. Well, this was the story for tortoise. What about the rabbit? This is the distance time graph for rabbit for the entire race. What kind of motion is represented by this graph? Well, here we see that unequal distances are covered by rabbit in equal intervals of time. Here, in 0 to 20 seconds, rabbit covers a distance of 10 meters. In 40 to 60 seconds, he does not cover any distance. So, unequal distances are covered by rabbit in equal intervals of time. So, this is a distance time graph for non-uniform speed or variable speed. So, if the distance time graph is not a straight line, then it indicates that the speed is variable or non-uniform. Now, since the rabbit is moving in one dimension and it is not changing its direction, then distance time graph will be the same as displacement time graph. So let us study this part by part. So this is the displacement time graph of rabbit from 0 second to 30 second. And what type of motion is represented by this graph? Since this displacement time graph is a straight line, that means the slope of this graph is constant. We know that the slope of displacement time graph gives velocity. Hence, velocity is constant and this graph represents a uniform motion or uniform velocity. This is the displacement time graph for rabbit from 30 seconds to 70 seconds. What kind of motion is represented by this graph? Well, here we see that as time increases, displacement of the rabbit remains the same. That is, the rabbit is not changing its position with respect to time. So we can say that the rabbit is at rest. Hence, if the displacement time graph of an object is parallel to the time axis, this is parallel to the time axis, we can say that the time is increasing, but the position of the object is not changing. Hence, the body is at rest. So here, the rabbit is at rest. And this is the displacement time graph for rabbit from 70 seconds to 100 seconds. We see that unequal displacement takes place in equal intervals of time. So, if the displacement time graph is not a straight line, then the velocity is variable. Because if it is not a straight line, then its slope keeps on changing. If the slope keeps on changing, then the velocity keeps on changing. And hence, if the displacement time graph is not a straight line, then the velocity is variable. Now, what type of motion is represented by this graph? We see that the time is constant, but the distance traveled increases. So, some distance is traveled in no time. Time is fixed. So, time taken is zero or no time. But some distance is traveled in zero time or no time. Is it possible? No. It is never possible. So, such a graph is meaningless. So, if we have a distance time graph or a displacement time graph which is parallel to the distance axis or the displacement axis, such a graph is meaningless. We can never have such graph. Now, this is the displacement time graph for rabbit and tortoise from t equal to 0 seconds to 30 seconds. The blue line is the displacement time graph for rabbit and the pink line is the displacement time graph for tortoise. Now, which line represents a higher velocity? We can clearly see that the slope of blue line is higher than that of pink line. That means the velocity of blue line is higher than that of pink line. So, the velocity of rabbit was higher. So, from t equal to 0 seconds to t equal to 30 seconds, the velocity of rabbit is higher than that of tortoise. Then how did the tortoise win? Well, what we saw was only a part of the race. That was only from time equal to 0 to 30 seconds. This is a complete picture for the entire race. This blue line is for rabbit and this pink line is for tortoise. We see that although the rabbit was running with a higher velocity initially, but later on he rested. And till the time he woke up, tortoise had covered a large amount of distance. And even after rabbit running with a very high speed after he woke up, he finally lost the race. So we see that slow and steady wins the race. The tortoise, although he was slow, he was steady. That is, he moved with uniform speed throughout and hence he won the race.